Coming up on this episode of We Come From the Future, we talk about the human microbiome and why it wrecks all our favorite science fiction tropes. We talk about Titan's water ocean, and we build a homemade microscope using a laser to see what's swimming around inside the water in the San Francisco Bay. All this and more on this week's episode of We Come From the Future. This episode of We Come From the Future is brought to you by HostGator. Hello, and welcome to We Come From the Future, the show where we stalk the future, kill it, skin it, and then wear it around town until PETA throws red paint at us. I'm Annalee Newitz.
And I'm Esther Gets Experimental. Today's show will be all about the microbial life all around us. You are covered with it, and you are riddled through with it. Scientists estimate there are 10 times as many bacteria, viruses, and eukaryotic entities in your body as there are human cells.
Basically, you're a walking ecosystem, and one scientific project has just finished up cataloging you. The Public Library of Science Human Microbiome Project has categorized 5 million different microbial genes from 18 areas of the human body. That's the whole human microbiome as we know it. Now we can understand humans as symbiotes. In other words, we're dependent on hundreds of other organisms to survive. It suggests many new avenues for medicine as we realize that our health depends on the health of all these little creatures that are living inside of us and all these complicated environments inside of our bodies. And also, here's your fun fact, this means that we left living creatures on the moon when the astronauts who landed there 40 years ago chucked their bags of poo out of their landers.
I don't think they're alive anymore, though.
But it's a 40-year experiment on what life on the moon has been doing for 40 years.
It's true. See, what I like is about this is we hear all about that movie, The Fly, where Jeff Goldblum like goes through a transporter and oh no, a fly gets in there with him.
Yeah.
And then his DNA gets mixed up with the fly and he turns into a fly monster.
There's like barfing and yeah.
If you actually look at all of this stuff, what it means is he was already going through with a ton of microbial life just all around inside him. So technically his DNA should have been switched with a gut bacteria. Or his DNA should get into the gut bacteria and they should all transform into little Jeff Goldblums.
That would have been a way more awesome movie.
That
basically
would have been a
Jeff
movie.
Goldblum's gut takes over the warehouse and like they're all running around and forming political parties.
Yeah.
I would have paid to see that. Well, you know, humans aren't the only microbe farms on Earth. Any water system has its own microbiome, and we're going to show you one now. All it takes is a laser pointer and a bit of wire to see the microbial life projected on the wall. Please join special guest Kyle Kurpinski in this week's Esther Gets Experimental.
Today we're joined by Kyle Kurpinski. He's a bioengineer and the co-author of How to Defeat Your Own Clone, and he's going to show you how to find life in pond water with your own homemade microscope with a laser.
So tell us a little bit about how this experiment is going to work. We've got our equipment right here.
Yep.
Just walk us through it.
Well, it's pretty simple. You don't need too much. Basically, to make your own microscope, optical microscopes, all you really need is essentially a lens, a light source, and a sample. And in this experiment, we've actually condensed the lens and the sample into one thing. So what we do is you get a standard laser pointer. This is like a pen laser pointer. Get them on Amazon, get them online. Take a piece of copper wiring and shape it so that it wraps around. We've used a little piece of tape to hold it in place. And the most important part is to make a little loop at the end so that you have a little circle where you can put your sample. And this morning I went out and I grabbed a sample of water from the San Francisco Bay.
Excellent.
So, got it right here. You basically get a little sample.
So basically the same principle as when you're blowing bubbles and you're kind of dipping your wand into the bubble stuff and getting a little layer of the...
Exactly. So the surface tension holds that little bubble in place, essentially. You have a little bubble of fluid there, and that creates its own lens. And within that bubble of fluid, you have all these little microorganisms that you can't see with the naked eye. So when you shine the laser through that bubble, the light gets refracted and it expands that image onto something else. So we can project the image from the laser onto, say, a giant white screen like this.
Wow.
Okay.
Yeah. So what were we seeing in there?
So mostly we think we're probably seeing a lot of protists and some algae.
So what are protists?
So protists are very small. It's a large group of microorganisms. They could be unicellular, they could be multicellular, and it really encompasses a lot. So it's sort of hard to say exactly what we're looking at. We can't
but
pick
that,
it out and say.
That little guy scooting across the screen, you think that was a protist? Or?
Most likely. Algae would not be so mobile. You'd see a lot of little circles, which is sort of what we saw, and then we see some swimmers, so you actually see some active organisms swimming around in
there. So what were they swimming with?
They might be swimming with flagella. Some of them move along more like worms, kind of just wriggling their body along. It just depends on the type of organism.
So flagella, is that, could that be considered tiny little tentacles? I'm wondering if we found Cthulhu.
I would consider them to be tiny little tentacles, yeah.
Yeah, right. Just like little baby Cthulhu. So just keep in mind, I guess, when you're drinking water, not just from the bay, but anytime, you're probably swallowing some little swimmers like that.
Some little elder gods.
Little protists.
Even in drinking water, you'll see some microorganisms. Obviously, if you pull water out of a pond or a bay, you're going to have a lot more.
Yeah, but you want those. I mean, you need to have a little bit of microorganism in your body.
It's all about the microbiome.
Yep.
Okay, thanks, Kyle, for joining us. Remember, boil all your water before you drink it. And now, a word from our sponsor.
Do you have a website or a blog? Why not? It's easy to do with HostGator. HostGator can get your blog or website up and running in minutes, and it's cheap, too. With plans starting at just $3.96 a month, you get 24/7 support and access to website building tools with over 4,000 templates. They'll even migrate your current site for free. Plus, HostGator's servers are also 130% powered by wind energy. For Revision 3 viewers, HostGator is offering 25% off your order, or your first month is free. Just go to www.hostgator.com and enter the code FUTUREREV3 at checkout.
This is awesome. Titan might have liquid water oceans.
Measurements taken by the Cassini spacecraft suggest that Saturn's moon Titan has an ocean of liquid water beneath its surface. Apparently, Saturn's gravity is deforming the moon in a way that scientists think means that the moon is basically squishy inside. And squishy means that there's a liquid ocean that's just sloshing around on that moon.
We already knew Titan has a thick atmosphere, ethan methane lakes, and even weather in the form of methane, snow, and rain. Now it seems like it may have an ocean made of water. Scientists say that this ocean might be erupting in ice volcanoes and even helping to create those methane lakes we were talking about.
Yeah, I feel like ice volcanoes makes Titan even more awesome. I'm totally ready to go. I want to dive into that.
I don't want to go there. It has an ocean made of fart.
No, the ocean is made of water. The lakes are made of fart.
So there's an ocean with a bunch of fart on top of it.
I'm still going. I'm going. I'm going to Fart Lake.
You're going along. Hey, if you enjoy watching We Come From the Future, or if you just want to see our production of Fart Lake, show us some love. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's easy to do. Just click.
In fact, you can get your friends clicking there too. Or if you're an iTunes person, search for us on iTunes by looking for IO9. And as always, you can find us here rehearsing Fart Lake at Revision 3. I'm Annalie Newitz.
And I'm Esther Inglesark-Kell. And we'll see you next week in the future.